Hey everyone, John Ross here from TestPrepInsight.com, and today I'll be comparing some of the top-rated online bachelor's in finance degree programs out there. I mean, let's face it, if you're considering getting your degree online, you probably realize by now that there's about 1,000 online universities. You've probably seen the commercials on TV for them or digital ads as you've surfed the internet on your phone. At this point, the amount of choices out there is almost overwhelming. But luckily, today I'm gonna cut out all the fluff and directly compare and contrast some of the most popular online national universities that offer finance degree programs in order to make your decision a little easier. So if you're ready, let's get to it. All right, welcome back. The five online universities that I'll be comparing today include SNHU, Purdue Global, Grand Canyon, University of Maryland Global, and Capella. These are arguably the five most popular national online universities that offer degree programs in finance. And I'll be comparing them across five different categories: affordability, institutional aid, AKA grants and scholarships, what the admissions process is like, program format, and X factors. In other words, what I see as the standout features of each degree program. And if at any point during this video you feel like you need some more information, make sure to check out the description below. I'll drop links down there over to each university's website where you can get a bunch more detail and learn about each program. So you're gonna definitely wanna check that out as you continue your research. Or you can always find more info on our website as well by just Googling Test Prep Insight, best online finance degree. That's always a great option as well. Okay, so first up, let's talk about affordability. And the best way to do that is to look at the tuition per credit that each university charges and how many credits are required for graduation. And as you compare the five schools, you can quickly see that SNHU is the cheapest by far. That is, unless you live in Indiana. And that's because in-state students only pay $280 per credit at Purdue Global. Or if you live in Maryland, and that's because University of Maryland Global charges in-state students a discounted rate of $306 per credit. For the rest of us though that live in other 48 states, SNHU is about the best bargain at $320 per credit, with 120 credits to graduate. And if you're doing the quick math there, $320 times 120 credits, and you're starting to get a little lightheaded thinking about the total cost to graduate, you should know that there are alternative education options out there for you if you're on the fence about enrolling in a full-fledged degree program. Or maybe you're going back to school simply to add a line on your resume. You may want to think about enrolling in a professional certificate or micro degree program instead. For example, Indiana University and Columbia University both offer professional certificate programs in certain disciplines within finance for a fraction of the cost. I'm talking less than $1,000, and these certificate programs are also much faster to complete. I'll link a few of these certificate programs down below in the description if you want to check them out. All right, so next up, let's talk a bit about financial aid, since I know this is a major concern for students. And when I evaluate universities in terms of financial aid, I always look at institutional grants and scholarships. In other words, what percentage of new beginning full-time students receive aid from the university itself? Because at the end of the day, pretty much anyone can go out and get a federal or even private student loan for themselves. I'm more concerned with how giving the actual universities are. So with that in mind, the big winner here is Grand Canyon University. According to the US Department of Education, over 90% of beginning full-time students receive some sort of grant or scholarship from the university, and the average amount of which is right around $9,000. So the big takeaway here is that if you're banking on a scholarship or grant to help you pay for college, Grand Canyon is likely your best bet. By the way, if you do plan on taking out student loans or you want to learn more about earning scholarships, be sure to check out the description below. I'll link a few sources and guides down in the text below the video screen so you can learn more and get up to speed on the different scholarship and student loan options that are out there and available to you. With that said though, there are still two more things that I want to call out here while we're on the topic of scholarships and grants. The first is that while SNHU does boast a lower percentage of students that they give grants and scholarships to, the average amount of the aid they provide to students is actually more than Grand Canyon at around $14,000. So that's something to keep in mind. The other highlight here is that Capella University offers a Progress Reward Scholarship that typically ranges from $8,000 to $15,000 to keep new students motivated and on track to earn their degree. That is, if you meet the scholarship requirements. Essentially, you'll need to successfully pass your first course on your first attempt, stay in good academic and financial standing with the university, and take 7 or more credits per quarter in order to be eligible. But if you do that, you're golden. Okay, so next up, let's discuss admissions. And this is an easy one. And that's because 4 out of the 5 schools are considered open enrollment universities. In other words, as long as you meet the basic requirements, you'll be admitted. Now, each university does have slightly different requirements and each follows a slightly different admissions process, but generally speaking, you won't have to take the SAT or ACT, there's no minimum GPA requirement, and in most cases, you won't even have to pay an application fee. So pretty painless from that perspective. You don't have to worry about how your application or transcripts stack up against others, which is great for students who might not have the strongest academic background. Now, the one exception here is Grand Canyon. This is not an open enrollment university. With that said, they do have a fairly high acceptance rate at around 80%, so still a very good chance you'll get in as long as you meet their high school GPA requirements. And if you don't, there's no real worry. You just have to meet the university's minimum SAT or ACT score requirements or their minimum GED cumulative score threshold. Okay, next up, let's compare program timing and schedule format across the 5 universities. And while we're on this topic, I should mention that unlike traditional brick and mortar colleges, these online universities offer start dates pretty much throughout the year, sometimes as frequently as weekly or monthly. So just know that you won't have to wait until the next semester or quarter to end. You can pretty much get started right away once you finish the admissions process. So now that you're aware of the start dates, let's talk about the format of each program, since I know scheduling and flexibility are key factors for a lot of online students out there. So SNHU, Grand Canyon, and Maryland Global work off of 8-week terms, while Purdue Global and Capella work off 10-week terms. And as you might imagine, the 10-week courses just move at a slightly slower pace than the 8-week courses. So the questions to ask yourself here are 1, how quickly do you want to move? And 2, how much time per week do you have to dedicate towards your degree program? If you want to progress quickly, SNHU, Grand Canyon, and Maryland Global might be your better bet. You can just roll through each course 8 weeks at a time. But if you have a full-time job or you're a busy parent, Purdue Global and Capella might be a better fit with their 10-week courses. It just depends on your individual situation. And by the way, if you want to get a feel for what a typical course structure is like at one of these universities, be sure to check out the links down below the video screen. All of these universities provide helpful examples and schedules so you can get a better idea of what to expect. All right, last up here, let's cover my X factors for each university. In other words, what's special or unique about each of their finance programs? But before I do, I should mention that every single month here at Test Prep Insight, we give away a $500 scholarship to one lucky subscriber, just as a way of saying thank you and to help ease the financial burden of higher education. It's super simple to enter. I'll throw all 3 steps right up here on screen, and I'll also have all the details down below in the description. It'll take you less than 10 seconds to enter, and hey, you could win $500 to help pay for your finance degree. All right, back to the X factors. And let's start with Purdue Global. My one highlight here is the fact that they offer an accelerated master's degree option as well. So if you've ever thought about getting your master's in finance in addition to your bachelor's, Purdue Global makes it pretty easy. Essentially, by earning a minimum grade in select courses, you gain entry into a shortened version of Purdue's Master of Science in Finance program. And as a result, you can complete both degree programs in less time and at a lower cost than completing both programs separately. So that's a pretty cool option for all you overachievers out there. Okay, for SNHU, I have 2 X factors. For 1, like Purdue Global, SNHU offers an accelerated master's pathway as well. The other highlight though is that SNHU offers a CFP board registered concentration track. So if your end goal is to become a certified financial planner, by completing this program, you'll fulfill the educational requirements you need to sit for the CFP exam. So that's a nice option for those of you who one day want to slap the CFP designation behind your name. All right, next is the Grand Canyon University Finance Program. And my one highlight here is that GCU students can participate in sponsored securities licensing classes such as the SIE and Series 7. So again, great opportunity for those of you who want to pursue a career in the securities field, you'll be able to take advantage of the Grand Canyon program to earn those designations. Okay, next is University of Maryland Global. And similar to SNHU, by completing the approved course of study, you'll be able to sit for either the CFP exam or the Certified Management Accountant exam. Again, great concentrations and certification options for those of you pursuing a career in these fields. All right, last up are my X factors for Capella University, and I actually have 2 of them here. The first of which is pretty minor. It's that Capella finance students get free access to the Wall Street Journal. Again, I know it's pretty minor, but still kind of a cool perk. Second, and more importantly, Capella allows students to complete a portion of their general education requirements through their affiliate, Sophia Learning, for an ultra low cost. essentially for only $79 per month, Sophia Learning offers access to a ton of self-paced gen ed courses, which can then be transferred to your bachelor's program at Capella. So overall, it's a great way to save money while knocking out a good chunk of your gen ed requirements. Okay, that about does it for this video. I know making a decision about something as massive as your education is extremely important. So I hope I was able to provide some clarity around all these online universities. Again, if you want to learn more about any of these programs, be sure to check out the description below for more information. I'll have links down there to each university's website, as well as other guides and resources related to scholarships and financial aid for you to check out. Also, if you're interested in another degree area outside of finance, be sure to check out our YouTube channel. We have a ton of helpful videos related to higher education. Anyways, as always, thanks for watching, best of luck, and we'll see you in the next one.